Ableton Live is organized into several well-defined areas where we'll do all of our work producing music. When we first open Ableton Live, we'll open up into a view called Session View. Now, a session is the project file where we'll do all the work producing music in Live. Typically, when we open up a new session, we see two blank MIDI tracks and two blank audio tracks. But for this demo, I'm going to open up a pre-existing session that is going to have MIDI tracks and an audio track that has a few loops. When we open up Live and we see Session View, it looks a lot like an audio mixer. It has faders at the bottom, and on top we have rows of what we'll call clips. Clips are going to be the regions that will have either MIDI data or audio data that we'll use to construct our arrangement. Right now I'm in Session View, but when I hit my Tab key, I go into what's called Arrangement View. In Arrangement View, I'm going to see all of the data, all of the MIDI, all of the audio that I've recorded laid out on a timeline from left to right. Now, this is very similar to any type of view that we'll see in other programs. Programs like Logic, Pro Tools, Cubase will all be organized according to this timeline. Now, for our work in this course, much of the work that we'll be doing will be in this arrangement view. Let's go back to Session View and take a look at a few other parts of Ableton Live. On the very bottom left corner, there's a very important window called Info View. Info View is what gives us the information on anything our cursor is hovering over. So if I go immediately to the right and hover over the instrument called OP808, I will see that displayed in Info View. This is the drum device that's used to playback in the first channel. Now let's navigate up to the top of Session View. This area is going to be called the control bar. The control bar is going to have a lot of different types of things that we'll use to either manage playback, recording, or various aspects of recording, such as overdubbing and looping. As I move my cursor to the left, I can see the tempo. We see here that the tempo is 121 beats per minute. And you'll see that Info View is telling me what my cursor is pointing to. This is the tempo that the entire project will play back in. And as I hover over the first number in the time signature, I see the numerator, the number of beats per measure, and the next will be the denominator, which is going to tell me what is going to be getting one beat, in this case, a quarter note. Okay, as I move over further to the right, I see transport controls. I see play, stop, and my record button. Now, if I want to play something, I very simply hit this play button. I can stop by hitting the stop. Now, what I can do is I can also use some key commands. So the key command to start playing and to stop playing will be the space bar. So if I very simply hit the space bar, I start playing. Hit the space bar again, I stop. It's the exact same thing as clicking on those icons. Okay, so you can also see in Info View that there are some handy key commands. So as I hover over the play button, you can see these displayed. It's going to be very helpful to you if you can learn some of these key commands that will speed up your work. Now the next thing we're going to take a look at is the browser. There are a number of different parts to the browser, but essentially this is where we organize all the sounds that we'll be using in our projects. As I select sounds, what I'm going to see here is a list of every sound that's available to me. Now, this is not going to be all that useful. So as I move further down, I can see more categories of sounds. So first of all, I can see all the different types of drum sounds that I have. As I move further, instruments, this will show me all of the types of instruments that come with Ableton Live. Now, these are MIDI instruments. They're software instruments that will play back data from our MIDI track. I have audio effects, and these are typical types of audio effects that we'll use to process the audio in our tracks. So there's a lot of different things that we'll be using the browser for, and we'll get back to that in a little bit. Now, let's go and switch once again to the arrangement view. Okay, if I select any of these tracks, what I'm going to see at the very bottom is I'm going to see a couple different views. So let's start out with track one. This is going to be a MIDI track that is being played with an instrument called Kit OP808. At the very bottom, what I can see is device view, which is showing me the device. Now, on the very bottom right-hand side, I can click on right next to this. I can click on this here, and this is going to show me clip view. Now, clip view is something I can expand to get a better view, but this is essentially going to be showing me all of the MIDI data that will be in this clip. And this is where we're going to do all of our MIDI data editing. Now, as I click each track, it's going to update that. So as I click on the second track, it's going to show me the MIDI data for C Dorian bass. And as I click on device view, this is now going to show me that it's being played by an analog instrument called Pure Wow Bass. So these are really very useful ways to navigate through this. Now, one other thing we want to take a look at in loops are, in this case, they're going to be audio. So as I select this and I click on what previously was device view, what I'm able to see is waveform view. And this is going to bring up the sample editor. This is going to be where we're going to do most of the editing for our audio devices. So these types of things are going to be really handy to navigate as we record and we edit in Ableton Live. Now, one other convenient feature, and again, just to review, I can select track 3, and this is going to be the piano part. I see the MIDI notes. I can right here go to the right, select device view, and I can see that's being played back by a device called Mark II, 3, old piano. But one thing that's kind of cool is if I move to the right of that, I can click on a series of bars and I can bring up the faders. So what's really cool is I can see these faders whether I'm working in arrangement view or working in session view. Now, these are all the basic areas that we're going to be used to be producing music in Ableton Live. There's a few other things that we're going to be looking at, but this is going to get you started.